What's a designer's favorite book? A MacBook. Well. So what is design? Is it this? Is it this? Or is it this? I think they're all correct, but I also think it's wrong. So I'm sure by now that you've heard of a bunch of fields that incorporate the word design in them. So like UX design or UI design or web design. There's also graphic design and interior design, fashion design. And there's also ones that people still associate design with them, but they don't necessarily have the word design in them. So I'm thinking like photography, videography. There's also architecture or animation. All of these practices, they're just creating things, you know? So a t-shirt or a mobile app, a website or a poster. It feels good to stretch. So is design a synonym for creating things or creation? I think it's part of it. I also think there's more to it than that. If you look at any product that exists today, so physical things like your phone or a camera, a laptop monitor, and also digital products like Facebook or Venmo or Yelp, ultimately they were all built to serve a purpose. Whether that purpose has stayed the same from the very beginning to the end, or it's been altered a little bit, but no matter what, there was intentionality at every single step of the way during the whole creation process or while they were building the entire thing. And to be honest, they're still being built. Okay, so design being a synonym for creating things. Let's go back to that. Again, I think that's part of it. I think the missing side to that is the intentionality aspect to it. If we bring it all together, you know, what is design? I think it's all about creating things with intent. If we take Yelp, for example, you know, they're all about connecting you to great local businesses. So at the heart of everything they do, every single product, every single feature that they build and ship, they're always relating it back to that core reason, you know, of connecting you to those businesses. They're always trying to satisfy that reason or that intent or that mission. I hope I'm making sense here. This makes a lot more sense in my head. Maybe I'm not explaining things right. I don't know. But yeah, that's just an example. Some people hate Yelp. Some people love Yelp. I personally enjoy it. But no matter what, you know, there's no product in this world that can satisfy 100% of the entire world. Everyone's just different. And now that leads to the fact that it can be pretty subjective to be able to say something is well designed versus another thing that is poorly designed. But that's something for another time. All right, let's go back to those three images. Now, why do I think that these are designed and that it's not designed? I think that these are designed because they're ultimately crafted by someone or people for a purpose, whether it's to be used by someone or worn by someone, but it ultimately served that, again, that core purpose. But I don't think that these three solely represent something that is designed because of the fact that you can craft anything. You can make a paper airplane or a new laptop or a new mobile application. There's so many things that you can build and create. It's not limited to just a mobile app or a t-shirt or something, you know, a poster. There's so many things you can create. So I think it's wrong to say that just these three images fully represent what it is to be designed. This is my bedroom. All right, that's enough for this video. I just want to share this thought I had with the rest of the world. So let me know if you agree or disagree. You can bring a unique and different perspective to this. Yeah, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed, give this a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. I'm excited to make more design videos. So thanks again and I'll see you guys.